American car, which is trying to take over the European cars. So the car which gave a compete to the European cars is the Chevrolet Corvette. Right now I'm wearing the badge right now. Chevrolet. I went to US the GM too. Hope you guys all saw that. Okay, right now let's get back into the topic. So the Chevrolet Corvette. When the first car came out, the Chevrolet Corvette, it was a concept, but when it came out, it performed like an underdog. Right now it's the American icon, guys. Like the power of the V8. Okay, now let me get back. GM is a big company in US. What we don't know is that it's the largest company in US. It's like, see, both of my hands, okay? At that time, only the Europeans had supercar. So Americans did not have no supercar at that time at all. So Chevrolet chief designer, Harley J. Earl, decided it's time to show Americans can build a supercar and it's only built for Americans. So they built the supercar, which is the concept car. So they used the Chevrolet Bluefin inline 600 engine and tuned it to make 150 horsepower out of it. So we know that design cost a lot of money. Like when they developed the Chevrolet Corvette C8, it cost them a lot. For the design, I heard that for the design of the body alone, they have spent around more than $1 million. So it's great value. But in those days, what Chevrolet did is that they used fiberglass. Fiberglass isn't that expensive, but it's a bit cheap. It's in the middle of expensive and cheap. So they used fiberglass to design the car and use it in the production car also. For the styling points, the Chevrolet Corvette, the first concept car, the Chevrolet Corvette, then it was named Chevrolet Corvette, but when it came out, it was only sold as a convertible for styling points. Okay, so only convertible, and later on it sold with the hot top, the second version. Okay, so that's the concept car made by the Americans. Then the car sets its debut in the New York Auto Show in 1953. Even before the car reached the New York Auto Show, Chevrolet chief engineer F.D. Cole saw the car and said, "The car was amazing and you guys have to do something and sell it." So that's it. The Chevrolet concept car became an overnight production car. So that's the concept car which is named afterwards, that it's the Chevrolet Corvette. So it's the American car built for the Americans, for the American family. Yes, American family, yes, of course, okay. Apparently, nobody bought it. So you think it's a huge loss? Yes, because of what? The engine performance, etc. Even though the first Corvette may have looked cool, but they drove like nonsense. Like what I'm saying, the nonsense is because it didn't drive good, it did not have no power at all. When you press the car, like the accelerator, you expect power. You want the ground. There's nothing. It's just like you have taken family cylinder, like 4-cylinder engine, and just throw it. No, it's a 6-cylinder. So you just throw a 6-cylinder engine right over there, and you expect a lot of power from 150 horsepower. I think it was when they launched the car, it was like 1,100 tons, I think. So it was close to that. So 150 horsepower for that one, it's very, very low. You expect, see, in the Audi Q's 150 or 145, something around that. But this one, at that time, 150 horsepower as a sports car. Do you expect that for a sports car? No. So nobody bought it, apparently. That's the reason. So that's the sports car with no sportiness, crumbly, etc. So nobody bought it. It didn't lure no customers to the dealership. Nobody apparently bought it. So it was a big failure for Chevrolet first because of the design of the car, and it didn't reach the customers' expectations. So first, the car was like a joke, like for to everybody. Chevrolet felt very bad for. Like at that time, Chevrolet had very good sales. When they launched a new car, they expect customers. Was there no customers? There is no customers at all. So it was a joke. Then, later on in 1953, they threw the inline six cylinder Chevrolet Bluefin engine in the garbage. I think I'm saying it's not the garbage, but I'm saying they threw the engine, they took out and they placed in V8. So placing the V8 gave them 195 horsepower to the vehicle. So it's a big improvement from 150, I think it was 150 to 195. But you don't feel that much, but you feel a bit, okay? Okay, so the Chevrolet Corvette was blessed with the V8, as I said right now. So since it was blessed with the V8, it has a nice growl, like the intake noise is very nice, the intake notes is very nice, and the performance is improved dramatically. And for styling points, etc., you get a hot tub. At the before version, even if you go on a ride, you have to get wet, and all the electronics are damaged, like things like the radio. You expect that. So the second version came with the same, but the second, we consider that second. So it came with a removable hot tub. So the removable hot tub, just like ours, the new C8 which has launched, it can be stored itself. It's a small one. The hot tub itself is a small one. Now, even though you give 195 horsepower to it, at the time it was great, like that much was enough. Right now we have more than 1500 horsepower car, like the new Koenigsegg Jamera, then the Bugatti Chiron, etc. So you have that much things. At that time, so the Chevrolet Corvette, what they did was that, the Chevrolet Corvette came alive in the market. Like the sales record just got high and high. Like everybody started buying the car because of this. Okay, even you expect more. Like even buying also, what Chevrolet did is that they started racing, winning, getting more and more podiums, just like Ferrari, but couldn't catch up with them. So even though as they got lot of podiums and won lot of things, they caught the customer's attraction and they looped lot of them and made a huge success with that. And young Eastern European immigrant started to get his ranks, like the ranks of his designing level in GM, his ranks improved, that's it, okay? So the person is Zora Arkas Dantov. So before even he came to GM, he was a gold smuggler. He drove fighter planes. He drove fighter planes for the French Air Force, etc. So he was a bit of criminal and thing. But one thing is important. What is that? You know, Zora Arkas Dantov, whatever he thought, he will go to the extremes to do it. Like whatever he wants, he will do it. Even if he doesn't have money lying in the road. Just for example, he's a rich person. Even though he's there, what he thinks, he will achieve it. Anyway, he was a Belgian-born American engineer. So when he saw the Chevrolet Corvette in the New York Auto Show in 1953, he fell in love with that, love at first sight. So what he did was that he thought he wanted to make the Chevrolet Corvette as the best car in United States, in the world itself. Even before the original C2 has been released, there have been more Stingrays, like the C2 models itself, the C2 Stingray Racer Marker version, I think it's a Marker version, and then the Mako Shaka. So even before the C2 came, these was being released, okay? Since Zora Arkas Dantov contributed so much for the development of Chevrolet Corvette, he was considered as the father of the Chevrolet Corvette Tron. Zora Arkas Dantov, let's call it Zora. Zora had an idea of making a mid-engine car. You know that mid-engine car gives you more better handling, better acceleration, better braking, better everything. No, we should not say everything, because in car industry, like me, I love cars, okay? What I will do, you should never say everything. What you have to do is that you have to explain everything, okay? Not just saying everything alone. I'll say right now, it will help in better ABS, like the braking will be more, better in the ABS. ABS have to work a bit less, so it's more helpful for the ABS. So these are some advantages of a mid-engine car. So Zora knew that. So he wanted to make a mid-engine car. When he called his mechanicians and his designers, they were like, "Daddy, it's time for making a mid-engine car." Zora, you're a crazy person. So Zora had an idea of making a mid-engine car, but nobody supported his dream. So his dream didn't vanish, but it will come later. So hope that's enough for you car nerds. Like, what's the best for, like, I'm not kidding, okay, just for saying, okay. I hope you understand for, like, why placing a mid-engine in a sports car is much better than placing in the front or the rear, okay. So the 1963, the C3 was launched, and it sold more than 50% than its predecessor, the C2. And it sold more than 20,000 units. So that's a great improvement for Chevrolet, and like the production was huge. So people loved it, and there was an attraction between the dealership and the customers. So together you get a Corvette. That's more than 20,000 units sold. That's a great improvement. So like a lot of people are trusting Chevrolet Corvette, and they love the performance and buy. In 1968, Chevrolet, they came up with another Corvette. That was the C3. C3 was the longest running Corvette and the best selling Corvette ever in the Corvette industry at that time. Why I'm saying it's the best Corvette is that at the first year alone, they sold more than 30,000 units in the first year alone. That's a great, great production. The C4, it was completely redesigned. Everything was redesigned, okay? So every part of the car was redesigned. Like Zora expected a mid-engine car, the C3 was expected to be a mid-engine sports car. It was perfect. The Ferrari, the Lamborghini, they all made mid-engine sports car for years, and they've been doing for years, and they have a freaking V10s behind. But wait, at the time they only had V6, V8 in the Chevrolet Corvette. They could just play a damn V10 engine and just boost the horsepower and give to the customer, make great sales. But they didn't do it. That's the problem. Why? That's the question. Why didn't they do that? It's because Americans, you are obsessed with V8s. Yes, I'm saying you are obsessed with V8s. No wrong. There's nothing wrong. So later on the C4, it came with a V6, not a V8. It's the first one that died. So they came with the V6, it's a bad thing. So they came with the V6 and they used the V6. Didn't produce that much horsepower. But at that time, what Lamborghini and Ferrari did was placing V8 behind, V10s behind, everything. V10, V8, so much power. Why Chevrolet? At the time, we didn't place at least a V8. I don't know, maybe designing something like there wasn't enough space in the engine bay to hold a V8. Maybe, we can't say. They are the designers. They know much more than me. And Chevrolet was tired and fed up of European sports cars. Why Lamborghini and Ferrari? What they've been doing? They've been defining the sports car. So Chevrolet just got fed up. They couldn't bear anymore. They said, shit, it's time for us to redesign our car and make ours as the best. So Chevrolet, they got back into job. They redesigned, they itched their skins. They redesigned the car and made it amazing. So what you get so much after many itchings, many hard work, many sweat, after all of this. So after all of this, what do you get? You get the ZR1, get 565 horsepower, the fastest production C8 ever, and the costliest for $117. You can't get for $117. It's $117,000, guys. So it's the costliest and like the expensive C8 ever produced. Sorry, Corvette ever produced. So it's the most expensive Corvette ever produced in the Corvette history. By the way, I forgot to say this information. The engine in the ZR1 was designed by Lotus and Mercury. Mercury Marine. They used to design boat engines. Whatever, just leave it. It was in the 1995, the C5 was launched and it was redesigned from the top to the bottom. So every piece, everything is changed or redesigned. So that's an amazing thing, okay? Then Chevy bought the Z06 badge, which was first used in the OG Stingray. So bringing the Z06 is a huge development indeed. Sixth generation Corvette, the 2005 model, took inspiration, a lot of inspiration, from the original Z06, the OG Z06. The C6 wasn't too different from the C5, except the styling changes, etc. The base model had a 6-liter V8, boosting the horsepower about 550 horsepower to 590 horsepower. The next year, the Z06 featured a small block V8 engine, providing a colossal 505 horsepower. Let's keep horsepower, it's very good. Then in 2009, again, Chevy bought back this ZR1. ZR1, guys, just like what I'm wearing in my badge right now. ZR1 badge, what you can see me, Corvette ZR1. This time, the ZR1 featured a 6.2-liter supercharged, providing 638 horsepower. Okay? 638 horsepower. But there was a problem. They were really competing with themselves, not with the other industries, nothing. They're just competing with themselves with the other older models, like the Z6, with competing with Z5, and the ZR1 package, the old ZR1 package, etc. They're just competing with themselves. Then, the new 2014 C7. It's old right now, but in 2014 it was a new one. So the 2014 C7 had an aggressive front. The bumper was so aggressive, it blew everybody's freaking minds. That's the thing, okay? It blew everybody's freaking minds. So the C7, So the best Stingray had 406 peg of torque under 0-60 under 3.9 seconds. 3.9 seconds. It's done by Audi R8. It has V8. Two cylinders less, okay? That's it. That's the difference. But still, you get 2.9. So you're doing it in... But still, you're doing it in 3.9 seconds, which are done by Audi, 911, Porsche 911, and even the Jaguar. Then Chevy brought back the Z06 and the C7, and it featured a V8 engine producing 650 horsepower. It was amazing. The performance was great, and it was just the performance was as equal to the Audi R8. Not completely, but it was equal, as equal, 1/2 of Audi R8. So the 2018 model has an onboard camera, so you can record your lap times. We know that only the expensive car like Lamborghinis and Ferraris get onboard camera. No, the 2018 Chevrolet Corvette Stingray model had onboard camera, so you can record your lap time, cornering angles, you can record your lap, like the track, and then you can see your steering wheel, like how you move, your acceleration, brake force, G's, everything. Chevy got you covered, man. Then we have the big news, the 2020 C8 Corvette, which blew everybody's freaking minds than the 2020, I think it was the 2019 GR Supra. It did nothing. What? It was just a BMW. I think it was the i4 engine right over there in the Toyota. So that's nothing, just 254 horsepower, 260, that's it. I think it was just like that. Waste. Nobody was like really interested. They were all eager, but it didn't blow the mind. Like the performance wasn't as good, nothing. But the 2020 C8 blew everything. Every competitors, like everybody was surprised about this, so they blew everybody's freaking minds. That's what I'm coming to say, okay? It blew everybody's freaking minds. I'm repeating it again because the 2020 C8 is so beautiful in nature. You see that you get 490 horsepower as a base model and you get 470 foot-pounds of torque. So that's a healthy numbers for that engine V8. And it, like everybody's absolutely happy, like how GM bought this. Like we got the track news, like when they create the car, you have to test it in the roads, so you just understand about this. Some of them took the photos, videos, etc. But still, you see, this C8 is the most beautiful C8 ever produced in the Corvette history and the most powerful right now. It's the best for its power. Like you see a lot of videos of the C8 right now, I'm pretty sure. You've seen that some people race their C8 with their Lamborghini Aventador. The Aventador gets blown away, then it reaches its top speed, Aventador reaches away. But see, it beats the first part, okay? The second part, it couldn't get to the speed. Okay, let's keep like that. It's only 60, under 60. Let's say you topped up. I love C8 so much, okay? I love Corvette personally, that's why. When I went to GM, you see my video, like in the last GM tour, I went to GM and took a whole tour of that. And I went to the final shop and got these badges. Hope you can see this. Like the ZR1 and the Corvette badge. I love this so much. It's amazing. I have got even two pairs of these guys. So yeah, the C8 is amazing. That's to be said. Now, let's get into this deck, okay? Just what Zora wanted. This C8 is a mid-engine sports car. What did Zora Arcus Junta want? He wanted a mid-engine supercar. It couldn't happen. He was deceased in, I think it was in 1958 or 1956, he was deceased. Deceased, okay, so some people didn't understand deceased or something. Okay, deceased, D-E-C-E-A-S-E-D. Deceased means that dead. It's another word of dead, okay? So he was deceased. So Zora wasn't alive and he couldn't fulfill his dream. But Zora, people still got respect on your parents. Don't worry, rest in peace. Okay, now let's get back. So the C8 is a mid-engine sports car. I personally went to the GM website and I customized my own C8. Like what I wanted, I customized the C8. I took the 3LT, Z06 package, everything maxed out. I took everything, I just maxed out. I went to the GM website, I like Corvette, so I did the Corvette 2020 and I created my own customization and it came around $108,000, that is okay. The whole car, only the car alone, it was less than $97,000. but I just added some bags, etc. So it cost me $109,000. I didn't buy a region where I live. There's no show in a dealership or nothing, so I couldn't buy the product, so it's a bad thing. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so you see, only $90,000. Let's see, someone is buying a $90,000 to match to a car. They've never known a car, matching out with a car, which the package gives you. Let's see, it has been under offer. Already some people have started supercharging it, making it straight pipes, long too much is doing it. So let's say, in this scene, coming scene in 2020 or maybe in 2020, is this thing that's over, I don't know what it is doing now. Okay, so I'm saying, it's going to make it harder. Customization, everybody is going to go quickly. What I'm saying to you is that they want to just change the driver, everything, that's it. But the only thing I say is the best thing right now in the Corvette. It has 490 horsepower, so the Z06, Z01 had, the older one had 65. So wait, hold on, hold your horses or hold your bags. Now I'm saying, this is just the C8, okay? There's no, this only has Z06 package, I don't think so. It's a problem. Okay, now for 490, the ZR1 package, the Zora edition, because Zora wanted this and it's a new. So they're keeping the next one as a Zora edition because of Zora himself. So it will be known as the Zora, the C8 Zora edition. So the Zora edition will give you around 1,000 horsepower. Let's say even 1,000 horsepower, how much will it have? So around 1,000 horsepower, maybe a V8, maybe a small LT2 engine, anything, it may be anything. But I think it's going to be less than 200 horsepower. So 200 to 260,000 horsepower. I think it will be less than that. To be said so, but even though it's the best. So that's it, guys. Hope you like my video. Please consider subscribing to my channel, and this vlog is over today, and peace.